Welcome here to TalkFCB and welcome back to the channel, guys, and welcome to a brand new week in the life of a Barcelona fan. And in today's video, we are going to be discussing some very, very pressing topics on a number of different issues. Starting, of course, with the extremely worrying reports surrounding Barcelona's financial situation, even right now, with the word bankruptcy being used. We're also going to be talking about life on the pitch in terms of our mischances and what is causing our problems in front of goal. And finally, we are going to be talking about Antoine Griezmann. Is he improving over the past few games, or is it much of the same? It's all coming up today. Let's get to it now. Come on! But if we do start first and foremost with the serious stuff, and I do mean serious, because we talk here about Barcelona's financial situation, and in particular, the real obstacles that surround the club and are really going to be pressing us in these coming days. This week could be a big week for the future of Barcelona as we know it. Because the concern certainly has been there now, not just recently, but let's be fair, over the past few months, past few seasons, under Bartomeu's leadership, we've all been aware of the precarious financial situation that we found ourselves in, especially after the man who's currently in charge at Barcelona as we speak, the managing committee president, Carles Tusquets, came out immediately after he took charge of the club on a temporary basis, after he'd seen the finances. The first thing, the very first thing that he said is the greatest short-term concern, it's the finances. It is the financial situation at this club. It's a massive worry. And he was very, very open about that. And he said that in the time that they were at the club, they were going to try and help that if they could. Which, again, it's not surprising. We all know about Bartomeu, while he's left behind. We all know about the way the club has been very much mismanaged. But to what extent? Because the latest reports right now from the media have actually given us some specifics into exactly how bad things are at Barcelona right now. We've all heard about the wage cuts. We've all heard about the fact they want the players to take on those wage cuts to help with the club's finances. But apparently, Barcelona need, in the next few days, to slash around 190 million euros from their wage bill in order to avoid being declared bankrupt by January. And that's incredible, and not in a good way, because to actually come here today in a video and use the word bankruptcy in connection with a club like Barcelona, that absolutely blows my mind. As big as Barcelona is, as much revenue as this club generates, and we're talking here about bankruptcy, it doesn't make sense. The figures do not add up. And like I say, this falls on Bartomeu. He has left behind here. He may have resigned, and of course we are very, very happy about that. But it should have happened sooner, because under his leadership, under the mismanagement over so many years, and now in addition to the pandemic, we've been left in a daunting situation. And like I say, this is a big week, because perhaps even more worryingly, it seems like the club need that resolution pretty quickly. The Spanish media right now are reporting that Thursday of this week, that's the current deadline. That is the time there where they want to wrap everything up, where they want to get those wage cuts completed. Will they do that though? We're going to have to wait and see, because talks behind the scenes are ongoing, not necessarily between the players themselves and the club. It's more likely to be there the players' lawyers and representatives talking on their behalf, because as you know, this is not a normal situation. This is not something, of course, that we're familiar with in football. Even with the COVID pandemic, you don't really see any other elite club in the world right now in this kind of situation, this bad as it's got at Barcelona. And in the coming days, all we can do right now is sit, wait, hope that, of course, an agreement can be made there between the club and the players, and whether Barcelona can reduce that wage bill sufficiently to stay well clear of that incredibly daunting word. And it's unbelievable. Bankruptcy. Surely not. Which then takes us to matters on the pitch, which haven't been all that more rosy. But I do obviously want to point out the fact that all this has been going on now for several weeks, several months. It's not exactly ideal for the players in this situation. I know they're very well paid. I know that, of course, they're very well looked after. But at the same time, it's not exactly the perfect conditions here for a team going out there to do their work, to play their football. And in the background, you've got confusion about your contract, about your wages. All of this stuff is not exactly ideal when you're trying to pull together in the same direction. But But I want to talk here about our finishing, because during our four-game winless run in La Liga, in front of goal, we have been dreadful. There's no two ways about that. I'm not saying the performances as a whole have been dreadful, because we have played some good stuff at times, but in terms of our finishing, when it comes down to it there in the final third, we haven't scored the goals that we should have. In those four winless games, we have attempted 54 shots in total. We scored just three times, and those are terrible numbers, because it means there that it's taken us an average of 18 shots to score each goal. You need 18 shots to score one goal. That's nowhere near clinical enough, and especially when you work out there the conversion rate from those numbers, it looks even worse. That would see us there at a 5.5% conversion rate percentage, which in terms of the season, compared with the rest of the clubs there in La Liga, those kind of numbers, it would put you towards the very bottom of any club in the division right now. And of course, that's not something that we ever want to see, but it does reflect where we are in the league right now. One thing though that I would say, one positive that I'd like to spin on this particular issue, is that actually I would rather be in this position. I would rather be in a position here where we're creating the chances, whereby clearly we are getting opportunities, we are cutting through teams, we are appearing in front of goal, but we're missing, as opposed to not creating them at all. I would still rather be in a position whereby right now, it's very frustrating. We're like banging our head against the wall. We're waiting for Barcelona to actually start firing in front of goal. But I would rather that than not be in this position at all, to actually be struggling to create chances, to be boring in games. I don't think you can describe any of these right now as boring, to put it that way. And I do feel as though, with the kind of players we have, with the quality we have in front of goal, you feel as though as the season goes on, the games to come, surely it can't continue. Surely at some point here, with Messi, with Griezmann, with Ansu Fati, with players there who can score goals, we know that this will come to an end. And when it does, when we start being more effective, we'll move up that table. However, just to point out one more thing about our effectiveness, or lack of it, in front of goal recently, I'd actually like to look more into exactly where we're taking on our shots, because it's not all about the fact here that we're missing chances. At times as Barcelona fans, we're watching on in the games and we're thinking, we're doing the same thing over and over and over again. Let's mix it up. And I know that I'm not alone here, because against teams like Itafe, like Alaves, who sit very, very deep, they park the bus, it's difficult to find a way through. We have struggled for this, not just this season, but for many years as a Barcelona team. I think what we'd all like to see a bit more of is shots outside the box. Shots taken on there, taking a chance, taking a risk. Even Ronald Koeman, after the game against Alaves, he alluded to it. So clearly there, it's something that can be implemented. Because when you've got Messi, who's an incredible ball striker, from free kicks and stuff, you know, he can bang them in from anywhere on the field. You've got Griezmann. You've got Coutinho, of course, when he comes back. Pjanic now as well. Even Trincao can really hit them. Sometimes, you've got to get that ball and just take on the chance. Too many times, I feel, in that final third, it's one pass too many. We're getting into good areas, we're seeing good sights at goal, but we're not taking on that chance, so we're trying to play one more pass and the move breaks down. I just feel as though sometimes you should mix it up, you should do different things, you should keep yourself unpredictable, and that's something I feel that Koeman maybe will try to bring into his team. Of course, though, one man who actually did put the ball in the back of the net for Barcelona against Alaves, it was rather surprisingly in some ways, Antoine Griezmann, who scored his first goal of the season in that game, the equalising goal, a very good goal that it was. And many people asking me here about Griezmann, whether he's improved in the past few games, what we can expect from him, and ultimately, whether he's getting the praise that he should be after maybe a bit of an upturn in form. And I think, to be honest, when you're looking at Griezmann here, you've got to be fair and say that actually I think he was against Alaves pretty unlucky because of the way the game went, because nobody, it is true that nobody is really talking about his goal or even really acknowledging it, because like I said, it was a really good goal that he created out of nothing. It was a good run in behind, he showed the ability there and the awareness to get to that ball first. When he got there, it was a great finish at a really key point in the game, and that was a good thing. It was a good thing to see from Griezmann, and it will help there with his confidence. And let's not forget either, just a few minutes later in that game, had Trincao just stayed onside Griezmann, he could have won the game for us. He'd scored another goal, it
probably would have been the winner, and then we would have all been talking about him, and he would have been all over the front pages. So I think Griezmann certainly will feel right now as though maybe he's not really getting recognised, not getting that praise, but at the same time, he's got to keep doing it. It's as simple as that. You're a 120 million euro signing. You've got to do this game in, game out now. You have to keep your head down. He's been much, much better in that central role. He's been more involved. He's been on the ball more. He's been creating, and he's been looking to score. And ultimately, that first goal, it should be a huge weight off his back. Now he should feel as though he can have a bit more freedom to go about his game and hopefully add to that tally. And what we're going to see him do now, this week, against Dinamo Kiev, against Real Betis, go and score more goals. You score against Dinamo, you score against Betis, and suddenly then, people are starting to say, yeah, Griezmann, he's contributing. This guy can be our forward. This guy can give us the goals that we need. Just keep working hard, keep your head down, and keep banging in those goals. And as always, guys, I am very, very interested to know your thoughts, particularly on everything that we have discussed in today's video, from the financial situation. What do you make of that right now? Very, very precarious times for this club. And not something, of course, that I wanted to report, but it has to be done, and it has to be said. Also, let me know your thoughts there on the chance creation and the lack of effectiveness in front of goal for Barca. And, of course, the form of Antoine Griezmann. I will see you tomorrow when all of the build-up will begin again for the Champions League. I'm excited for that, and hopefully this can be a really good week before the international break. I will see you soon, guys, and I thank you indeed for watching. But until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça!